Welcome back to our Chronicles of Narnia, the Voyage of the Dawn Treader Sky Movie Special. We're here at the world premiere and the Royal Film Performance, which means Her Majesty the Queen will be here shortly, donning some rather fine 3D spectacles to see the movie. But here's what happened a couple of days ago when I caught up with some other royalty. Narnian royalty.
Aslan.
You have returned for a reason. You have come far. And now your journey lies beyond.
It's nice to see you two again. I haven't met you before, Will, but it's great to have you back. The last time I saw you guys, I got a massive kiss on the cheek. It might have been from you, Skander. It was definitely from you. And then, tell them the truth, you honestly walked in and didn't remember me.
That is quite true.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable. So you're back for the third instalment.
Yeah.
Give me an idea of the story. Where do we head to in this one?
It starts off with us in Cambridge with Will's character Eustace. And, you know, just me and Skander, because our family is in America.
Have you seen this ship before?
Yes. It's very Narnian looking, isn't it?
Yeah. Just another reminder that we're here and not there.
There once were two orphans who wasted their time believing in Narnian nursery rhymes.
We come into Narnia and a big voyage is going on believe it or not, the Dawn Treader. And Caspian's king now, he's been king for a while, and it's him on a journey to find some advisors to his father.
I think in sort of honour of his father and part of him sort of to learn about himself, he goes and he's like, I'm going to find these men and save them from whatever, from wherever they are. And then he bumps into, in the ocean, Lucy and Edmund Pevensey.
Caspian!
Lucy!
He hasn't seen in 3 years, and Eustace Scrub, the bratty cousin, who he unfortunately takes on board, and then they have to go on these various and fantastic adventures together.
You are all about to be tested.
Edmund, come with me.
I can make you my king, and much more.
No!
Onward to our destiny!
There's a couple of years gap between the second one and the third one, particularly for you guys. What's it like being back?
Well, I mean, it's great when we go out onto these films. We have, like, you know, 6 months where we're with each other every day, and it's just a shame that then we get back and our lives just don't cross paths really. Georgie lives in Yorkshire. Will lives on the other side of London. You know, it's much harder to actually meet up. But then when we're together, it's great, and it's as if we've never left.
Wow! Oh, that's really cool!
So, Will, what was it like for you coming into a group? Because, I mean, obviously, these guys are pretty close already, yeah. You know, two films in. What was it like for you?
Oh, you know, I exactly as you say, you know, it's a close-knit group and all that kind of stuff. So I was quite nervous about that. And obviously, you know, being kind of the new boy and stuff, it was a little bit daunting, but these guys are so nice, you know, and made me feel so welcome. You know, we all got on so well, and I really appreciated that, like work-wise, being an experience and stuff. Really grateful for that, and also just on a social level, you know, just to have nice people to hang out with. It was really cool.
And what was it like working on such a huge film? Because obviously, you know, a lot of people will know you, of course, from Son of Rambo, but to go on to this film, it's big budget. You guys are special effects, and there are creatures that, I don't know, maybe you don't even know what they look like at certain points.
Yeah, I know. Well, that was, yeah, very different for me. You know, I never experienced anything like it before, and, you know, I felt a bit like a kid in a candy store. My jaw was just sort of dropping at everything we were looking at, and, you know, it was amazing. And I think these guys were saying, you know, it's going to be things that might be a bit scary at times, and they were right, but it was so enjoyable.
Dark Island. A place where evil lurks. It can take any form. It can make your darkest dreams come true. It seeks to corrupt all goodness, to steal the light from this world.
How do we stop it?
You must break its spell.
Let's talk about the Dawn Treader.
Yeah.
I mean, the Dawn Treader, this movie is all about that ship. Talk me through the acting process. Did you have a boat? Did you build a boat? Were you in a boat?
Was there a boat?
There's
a boat. There is a massive, beautiful, full-scale boat, but no, with no bottom, so you couldn't put it in the water because it would sink. But they put it on a gimbal on a peninsula, so we were surrounded by water on three sides, and the boat would move to mirror the movement of the waves. and they could sort of twist it depending on the angle of the sun or where you wanted the camera, so it was very kind of user-friendly. And then they disassembled the whole boat and built it again in a studio, surrounded by blue screen, so we could have storms with the rain, we could bring the rain. That's like proper, like,
yeah, I'm liking that.
We could bring the rain, we could have waves, we could have serpents attacking from the side, we could have judder, you know, judders, like the serpent hits the bottom of the boat and you kind of, you're knocked off balance. And so we did everything we could to make it feel very real. I think it works really well. And then they took a trawler ship out on the ocean and filmed that on the waves, and then they transformed that into the Dawn Treader, so it looks like the Dawn Treader on big wide shots. The only time we were in the water was in the rowboats.
Did you get seasick on a gimbal? So the gimbal is a giant thing that's pushing you around.
It's a massive big sort of platform, but it's mechanized. And I didn't get seasick, but some people did.
Because I'm guessing that's as close as you can be being on the sea without
being on the
sea.
Yeah, I think it's just a movement. Like some people get sick on roller coasters. It's just kind of the same kind of
thing. We call them wimps.
Yeah.
What can we expect more from this film that maybe we didn't get in the last couple of films? What's new?
It's its own film. It's its own storyline. It's got its own, it's got new characters. You've got different sort of character arcs within that. I mean, yes, you can look at the whole trilogy or so far and see, entire character arcs. Edmund sort of gets tied. Edmund and Lucy get sort of tied off in this film, but sort of within it, you have distinctive storylines within it, which are interesting, and they play with many different issues, which you haven't seen in the previous films.
The question that I think most people want to know is: this going to be the last one? Is this goodbye to Narnia?
I don't know. I mean, the fourth film is something that obviously it's been raised because of the books, and I'm sure everyone wants to see the series continue. With these guys making Narnia so popular so far, but I guess we're we've just enjoyed the third one, and wish it sort of all the best really in terms of how it does and things, and we'll just have to see. But I think the saddest thing if it is to continue is that these guys won't be doing it. So I think everyone's got to go out and see these guys in the third one.
Let's talk stunts, because I know in the last film you guys did a lot of your own stunts, didn't mm-hmm. you? Was that something that you purposely wanted to do?
I remember this one time when they said, now can you do this, special role and then land? And I just sort of realised, I tried it once and it was a bit awkward. And and there are times you've got to think, okay, I'm not a stuntman. Like, I've got to give it over. Like, it's going to take that guy a quarter of the time. It's going to look four times as good. Let's just get it done and let's move on. But there were definitely times when I was wanting to embrace it and wanted to be like, yeah, I want to go and do that. And I want to have a good shot at it.
I had a bit of a bad experience when I was sword fighting, which probably means I should never do my own stunts again. I actually forgot to duck in one of my sword fights. I got a black eye. So I felt really bad for the stunt guy who did it, because he's literally one of the gentlest guys like I've ever met in my life. Mm-hmm. And he was feeling awful about it. But I think that was kind of a memo to me saying, don't do your own stunts. But I still kept on going.
So I think we can all learn something from that. If you see a sword coming towards you, dark. What about you, Will?
I got to do the odd bits of, a few falls mainly and taking hits rather than dishing them out. But, really good fun. Stunt training was one of the most enjoyable parts of it, and Alan, the head stuntman, was just amazing. We had such a good time with him and all his kind of his stunt boys. They were awesome, and just like it was just so much fun doing it.
I remember talking to you guys, particularly for the last film, for Prince Caspian, and there was a lot of practical jokes on set. Mm-hmm. I can't imagine any of you have grown out of it. Best practical joke from each of you, please.
There was stuff which happened every day, but it never registers because, like I said, it happens every day.
I think Ben, being the oldest, he got a lot of kind of when we were filming on the spit and stuff and on the beach and things like that. Ben would just get piggybacked, wouldn't he? He'd just get forced piggyback. There was a lot of jumping on Ben. That was most of the.
I seem to remember a lot of people played tricks on Ben in the last film. Ben seemed to be the one that got it.
It was very sad. I think it's just because he's the oldest. Of course, we think he can take it. But do you remember when it was his birthday? We were filming the last scene of Narnia, and it was his birthday. And he was just kind of walking down, and like Will said, we all jumped on him, giving birthday beats and stuff. So that was fun.
Birthday beats.
Yeah, that's how much.
Happened to the old days when you got the bumps? Now you just get brutally beaten up for celebrating a birthday by your own castmate. Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah. Narnia's changed. A pleasure as always. Mm-hmm. Thank you very much. Great
Thank
to see you,
you
guys. Maybe
kiss.
Another little cheeky kiss, Skander. It's worth a try. Great to see you guys. Cheers. Thank you very much.
Good to see you.
Now is the time to be strong. Never give in.
No fear, no retreat!
Well, that's it. Time to go. Her Majesty the Queen is just around the corner and she's asked me to save her a seat. I might even get her some popcorn. Well, it is Christmas. Have a great holiday and I'll see you in the new year.